pouring most of our to that. It didn't look like our team didn't compete well enough. First, second contacts, 50-50 tackles, didn't come out of any of them, and we didn't use the ball well enough, so it's not a great mix. Never really got going from the first couple of minutes. It took us too long to realise where we were getting joy, and even then it was too slow. The Forest game would come away from home and they've set up camp the way they want to. I imagine we had most of the ball, but we didn't do a lot with it. They were a lot more threatening team than us, so no arguments for the result.
Is that the voice you played for?
Yeah, but that's a sign of how well we play. You can't be brilliant every week. The league doesn't let you. This is a division where no one does go unbeaten. So how do we react? We've not all of a sudden become a brilliant team. They've gone top of the league today, and in the last few minutes there's a few scares that we were right in the game to the last minute. And that with us not doing what we normally do. So yeah, it's disappointing. It's disappointing when you get the one, you don't really want to have the off day against your local rivals in front of a pretty much full house, but it happens. We haven't become a great team overnight, we've not become a bad team because we lost today.
What do you say to the players at half time?
That we weren't winning enough first and second contacts and we're using the ball too slowly. After three passes, they had the whole team behind the ball all the time. We weren't penetrative enough, we needed to switch it and then split them. We didn't do it, and then first half particularly we needed to go, because they blocked off the middle, play around the outside. We actually got round the back of their backfield two or three times in the first half, but we needed to do it constantly, we didn't.
What was the thinking behind the change you made at half time?
A couple of things. Wanted a bit more physicality in the middle of the pitch. It could have been anyone, to be honest. It could have been 1-11. I thought we were that poor first half. So obviously Rags had been on a booking as well, and the way they were looking to play, they were looking to counter, so someone might have to take one for the team, and he wouldn't have been in a position to do that. So I thought Rowan done well when he came on. He showed what he's about. And Connor's quite happy out there at right wing back as well. So we felt we needed to change something because what we were doing wasn't good enough.
When Nick Varley scored to get you back into it, at that stage did you think we could still get something at this?
Yeah, I thought we could get something in it from half time. I said that to him, just try and get the next goal and see what happens. They killed the game well. I thought it was a really bitty game. I thought the referee blew his whistle a lot. But that's, like I said, the credit to them, they've come away and delivered a good away performance.
Any complaints about your own yellow card?
I don't really get involved, to be honest, yes, but no. I'll just get on with it. It's not going to change anything.
It's clearly been a really good run, both overall in terms of games and here at home. I guess it's now a case of saying to the players, like, show them what you're about, now let's off we go again.
Yeah, exactly that. It's we've been on a good run and we've had a lot of plaudits along the way. We've never thought that we'd become a brilliant team. After 16 games last year, we had 10 points. So we've improved because we've played 15, we've got 28. So we have improved, but at no point have we said we're the real deal. A lot of hard work, a lot of things need to fall into place, and today was the day where we just fell the wrong side of the coin on pretty much every department.